Hello, guys, and be very welcome to our campaign with the Kingdom of Alba in the Last Kingdom mod for Medieval 2 Total War here on Double F Games channel. And so, last time we left off, we kept on squashing, let's call it like that, the rebels on Scotland. We've actually taken Dunfries with our king, and we've taken Iona as well. And so we are keeping on surveilling all the little isles around Scotland. That actually some of them are still rebel, and some others are being taken by the Vikings, which have stormed in the Scottish lands. Look at this. They are besieging this island here. They have another army here, and they have another army besieging us at here, in which our king is, actually. King Causantine. We've actually managed, actually, as well to get some trade agreements and alliances with the Anglo-Saxon kingdoms, especially with Mercia, which is our biggest ally right now, and probably will be against an eventual war against Northumbria, which will be on a later stage of the game. And we have managed as well to bring a merchant up to Iceland. Mr. Dub is here trading some gold, which is generating 495 florins per turn. That's a lot, man. That's a lot. Actually, where's my diplomat? Yeah, there he is. I want to bring him up here so I can put him on a ship and try to land him here on Normandy to talk with the Normans, and then with the Franks, and eventually with the Viking nations around here, Viking tribes, if you will. So today we're gonna have the defense of Herr for sure against this mighty Viking force, and probably we'll try and go to conquer Dunbergain. Oh god, I don't know. The names I keep saying, and I believe this is true. The names are really unpronounceable for me.
Yes, my king.
Okay, I want actually to send this spy this way. Just to check out where the other settlement is. I got it. They got this settlement as well.
At your service.
They have like three forces here and one other here. We're being completely encircled by him. Yeah, it's gonna be a while, guys. It's gonna be a while before we go to Ireland, as we were planning on. First, we have to fend off against these freaking Vikings. And we were preparing an army, if I'm not wrong, at Inverness. Yes, to put here on this unpronounceable land, with one of our most veteran generals, Tanaiste. And then he was supposed to go to here. Okay, so we'll see. I will pass the turn and we'll see what happens. Okay, they leech at air. Curious. And now they're raiding Wessex as well. Oh god, they're raiding everything. Winchester. They're raiding everything on every place. Okay, they left here and they moved towards Dunfries. So I might actually strike them. I might strike them so I make sure that their threat is no longer a threat. That's a pretty nice general here, but I have enough right now. I think I've explained this last time, that I don't like to have a lot of generals around. There we go, Vikings declared war on the Kingdom of Wessex, we've seen that. And our relations with Northumbria are very good. I don't really care for our relations in Northumbria right now. I really don't. Although, of course, if we are going to have this big war against the Vikings, at least a defensive war, not definitely not a conquering war, because they have no lands, they're just a Nord faction, we are better off without another war with the Northumbrians, you know. It's better they keep on their lands. It's much better. Okay, so I wonder if going against them, I'm going to have any advantage. I guess the best advantage would be to be defending. So, I'll see what happens. If they do besiege Dumfries, I'm going to go there and break the siege. If they don't, I'm going to keep on waiting for them to attack me at here, because I think that's the best position we can have, really, in order for us to defend ourselves. Here I'm going. I was recruiting another ship. I don't really recall why. I guess it was a transport ship for the islands. But I'm going to actually first recruit some other troops. I think it's the best idea. Okay. Yeah, they've taken the Isle of Skye. They've taken it. Let's get this armored warband here. Oh god. I didn't get that. I actually might put these guys in Inverness and then send them there. I want to see where their settlement is though. Vic. There we go. And here I should send Garrick McGrath, Rebel Slayer, towards Dunbegane. Although, I really want to check it out first. Okay, it could be worse. It could be worse defended. Although, they had another army here, right? I wonder. Problem is that these guys cannot retrain, because this is a village. They cannot retrain there as well. They can only retrain at Inverness or here, which is kind of a problem. Even so, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to take them out of Iona. Put the taxes down. I'm just going to leave someone behind. I can actually recruit a mercenary. Ooh, those guys are expensive. In terms of upkeep, look at this, 400, 310. I know what, I might recruit them both just for a safety net. And I'm going to leave these dudes behind, because they are the weakest unit. Ooh, and I can keep the taxes up. And I'm going to go there, and can we storm in? We can, but, well, we might just besiege them to see if we can make some of their units starve. Let's see where the other army was. I don't want to rush things up, you know, guys. I want to have a, you know, a calm campaign overall, but I think this is an opportunity for us to just swap in here and try to take this as quick as we can. Because I'm really afraid that the Vikings, I mean, they are an old faction, which means that they don't have original settlements. But the problem is, and maybe you guys can actually help me on the comments, if you know the mod better than I, if these dudes get to a settlement, can they retrain and recruit troops like an ordinary faction? I don't know this, because they are an old faction, but I guess they can. So the quickest we take them out, the best, so they can't get to any other settlements, and they can't retrain their forces and recruit more. Because I wonder if they can. I really think they can, because, well, they might have started like conquering maybe this island here, or this one here, and they probably expanded because they recruited some dudes around. I'm guessing that's a possibility. But we'll see. We'll see in the comments if you guys tell me something. I am actually curious about that. Do they... Are they able or not to to recruit units, you know? Like an ordinary faction, once they get to a settlement. Okay, we wait 2 turns here, so we'll probably have this battle today, which is going to be interesting. It's going to be our first battle against the Vikings. And I guess Taneisti and his forces can go to Inverness now. And when he's finished with recruiting, he can go and take Vic and then take this other island. I guess that's a good option there. So let me see if I can get out of here.
Marching now.
Yeah, I can. So get there. Might actually leave these dudes behind, just to keep a garrison. And here I think I'll keep on recruiting. Why not? Okay. Here we are recruiting as well. Let's retrain. Get me that ship when you can. Let's keep building something. Something that gives me money. Barley farm, that's perfect. No, actually, I want a trading post because I can recruit a merchant from there and I can send them to Iceland. Because I guess they have another gold mine there. They have one here and they should have... Yeah, they have another one there, so... We can send another merchant there and then we can send some merchants down to Germany. Here, Hamburg. I guess they have salt. Is that salt? Yeah, I guess it is. And it could give me some money as well. Let's keep bringing this dude up here. You were mistaken. Where did that army go? I don't know. They had another army. Oh, there you go. Okay, let's keep an eye on those dudes. Okay, let's finish the turn. Let's see if they besiege Dunfries. If they do, I'm going to take out the army from Eire and I'm going to break that siege. And they probably will break the siege here as well. So we might actually get 2 battles today against the Vikings. I don't know. Might see a very aggressive one. Oh! They actually didn't besiege me anywhere.
I'll rip off your head and spit on your neck.
Ooh, they can actually swap in either Krynan or Dunedain. No, they can. They can, because these are just villages, and they can just attack in one turn. They don't need to build any siege equipment. So I might just need to attack them. Oh, there's a new girl born, Anguzina. Who is her? Daughter to Domnall the Mad. Granddaughter to our king. Okay. Well, I guess I will attack this dude now.
I'll rip off your head.
I guess it's better to do so than to let him take one of these settlements. Diplomatic information. Kingdom of Munster against Kingdom of Connacht. These are good news for us. Because both the Irish factions are at war with one another, so they might just, you know, kill each other off, so when we get there, it's going to be easier to take them out. And Mercia is at war with the Vikings. Okay, so they are suffering, our allies are suffering the raids as well. Oh, and they have already established themselves here, so it seems. Oh god. They are storming in Britain. Okay, I will strike you here.
Aye, sire.
When I can. These guys have a lot of public order. I'm happy about that. I really am. I could do with... No. These number of archers are actually pretty good. I want to do a full stack here before I go to Vic. I know it's going to take a while because... We just have a recruitment slot, but I guess it's better for us to get a full stack than not. Let's see if I can build another trade post. Inverness. Yes, I can, so I can get more merchants. That's nice. Can I build something else that gives me more money? I don't want elf, I need money. I can do forest clearings as well, so they can give me some population growth. It's always nice to have that. So my settlements can not be only villages. Okay guys, I guess we're gonna have this huge battle here. And take my king. I'm gonna strike them. Dear god. This dude is only a captain, but he gets all these extra points. Although I wonder if I am strong enough to take him. I guess I can recruit some mercenaries and then I can disband them. Just to help me. I'm gonna recruit another archer. And I guess 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have a lot of spears, don't we? Although these island clansmen are not spears. They are not. So I only have 2 spears, really. So I would have 2 more spears, please. Ooh, which are better, this or this? The Pictish spearmen are better. Okay. Let's get 2 of them. And our king gets a mercenary captain. Very good. And now I am a little bit more confident about this. But still, I'm not too much confident. Because they got these Ferdengri? I don't know how to call them. But those carls are the ones which I'm more afraid of. And they got an horse unit, Ridaral. Okay, I'm going to try and prove our mettle against them. This could be the death of a king. I hope it is not. This weather is the worst. I need a little bit better, so I archers to do something. Okay.
God's blood! We'll give those vagabonds something to look miserable about. At them, lads! At them!
There we go, a short but fear-fueling speech from our king, Cosentin. And we have the disadvantage because they are defending and they get the better terrain, I guess. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to try and go around here so we can get a good terrain as well. Pick up our archers, let's put them in the front. Let's pick up our spears. And the rest of the infantry, I'm just going to put them on a large plump of an army. Look at this, a large force. Oh, I have actually an extra spear here. I haven't even noticed. General here, and let's start it. You know, they could come at us. Sometimes they do. Yeah, it seems like they are doing, actually. So Let's bring the spears in. Let's make the infantry. Let's take our general here. Be careful to not be flanked by their cav. Yeah, they're coming at us, aren't they? It seems like it. No, they are not. What are they doing? I don't know, are they dividing their forces? Doing some kind of weird formation? I don't know. I fear I don't understand you, Vikings. Okay, let's advance towards you then. If your strategy is to tire us, I hope you are not successful in that. And the range of our archers is a little bit crap, isn't it? Just move a little bit more. You can shoot something. Yeah, one of you can, so let's shoot them. They are shooting as well. I could put them on loose formation, but I guess it's too late for that now. We are winning the skirmish anyway. Look at them. I don't know if their archers are superior to us. I don't know. But I guess we are getting the advantages because we got to that hill quicker. Not necessarily because the hunters are better than these Viking archers. Okay, they're bringing in spearmen. This is light infantry. Okay, archers, flee back. Where are the horses? Did I see some horses? Yes, I did. Some reader are right there. Ready to go against our infantry. Ooh. Back there. King, my king, Constantine, get there. Run away. Run away. And we have been engaged. That calf would be perfect. Oh god, you got engaged, but you don't run away. You're so stupid. Get there! Quick! How are we doing? We're doing fine for now. Let's bring some dudes here to the flanks. I can't see my dudes. It's all a mess. Go there. Actually, all infantry engage now. Sorry guys, I'm not showing you the battle up close. I really like to do that, but and I have to concentrate on so many units. It's kind of a difficult thing to do. But I guess we are winning this for now. That cav is being shot down by our archers. And I want to bring my general around here so he can do a charge on their back. Oh god, they've broken this flank? What's going on? Okay, now I can show you a little bit up close. Okay, Kev, come here, engage. Charge them. You archers, please shoot there. You shoot there. You shoot there. They still have a lot of dudes coming in. Okay. Did that charge work or not? I really don't know. Oh! They're fleeing. Okay, come here. After these guys really need a massive replenishing. I guess they really got a beating here. Now, charge here, this flank. I don't know if this flank is worse than that one, really. Shoot them at the back. Okay, they are routing. Haha! Nobody can survive the wrath of the Scots. Not even the mighty Vikings. Or are they that mighty, as they say? Okay, you go here, you. Oh, now they are coming for our archers. Their cav is gone. Why did our freaking archers engage? Because they are not on the defensive stance. I forgot about this every time. Okay, run them. Run them down. Don't let them escape. You are not engaged, so get engaged. You archers, please get there. So I can shoot them on the flanks. You shoot them there, and you shoot them there. This berserker. Oh, look at them! Once again! They are naked. Half naked. On the cold winter. I don't even know if this is winter or not, but it's Scotland, right? It's always winter there. Okay, you have to charge these dudes. They are light infantry, so they should go down pretty easily. Now, you see, I hate this. Because it says it's light infantry and then they get some spears. But no problem, my cav is actually doing a nice job against them. They routed. I guess a lot of these units are not actually Viking units. They might have recruited some mercenaries as well. You know, like these dudes. No, these are Vikings for sure. These are Vikings as well. But you know, these guys are Vikings as well. So I might just be saying crap here. But I guess I saw some units from them which were clearly not Viking. But we're Saxon. Okay, and our dudes did not rout one bit. Oh, but they got our archers here. Oh, these guys are tough. try to kill them. These dudes are still 19 of them and they didn't rout.
The enemy are badly bloodied. They have lost half their men.
Okay. Keep pushing. Okay, there are some people here which are is not engaged. Get there. Yeah, we lost a quarter of our forces, that's not too bad. Let's get our general out of there. Quick, because they are coming with some spearmen, which are light infantry for some reason. Yeah, but I guess we've done alright against a superior army, which had units with a lot more experience than ours. So, yeah, that's, overall it was a nice treat. We might have lost like a unit of archers or two. Actually get them here and try to save their brothers. Bring our general around. Oh, those guys finally broken. You see, those dudes don't seem Vikings. They seem like pure Celtic units. So they might be actually some mercenaries that they might have recruited. Okay, they are routing now. Routing like wildfire. Let's see if our general can still come here. The archer are actually holding quite nicely against them. I'm surprised they didn't rout yet. Oh, they have no more shots on them, do they? They don't. Okay. This Erdman. Oh, these Erdman, they look nasty. Look at them. They look nasty. Okay, they're all routing now. Let's be at them. Okay, these guys are spears. Let's get the hell out of there before our king dies. But I hope after this battle he gets like two extra stars or something on his command, because this was a pretty nice victory. It really was. I guess it was his most important victory yet. I mean, last time he actually faced off against two rebel armies, which were almost two full stacks, but you know, their units were kind of crap, so against the Vikings, now he did a nice job. He really did. I mean, if you check the veterancy from these dudes before the battle, you would have seen that they were very, very veteran. So, he actually done pretty nice, I guess. Yeah, we lost 32% of our forces. We might even lose up to 35 until the battle is over, but I guess it was a nice result after all. But and then we can retrain all these dudes at air. And it's gonna be nice. It's gonna be pretty nice. And so I guess I'm gonna take those mercenaries actually. They were pretty cool. And they are not really mercenaries. For instance, this Pictish spearmen, they're just like our regular Pictish spearmen, so makes not that much of a difference, right? Oh god, our fucking general. Now I get why he's such a crappy general, our king. Oh god, for a moment there, I read general, for a moment I thought it was our king. Oh god, there you go. It was only a captain though. It would be much nicer if it was a Viking general, a mighty Viking general. It wasn't. I guess we are not going to take all of them out, but we might get a substantial part of the army. I'm thinking, can we get to 90%? There's still some dudes fighting. These Erdmen, they are going for it. Well, what we know from the Viking culture is that they fought to die, pretty much, so they can go to Valhalla. So, I guess it makes sense. But they're going to die nonetheless. That said, I'm going to keep these mercenaries. And I'm going to cancel the recruitings I'm dying, the recruitments I'm doing at Air, and I'm just going to focus on retraining these dudes, and then I'll see where I sent my king. I probably will send him to Ireland, because I guess the Viking threat on the south part of Scotland is over with the destruction of this army. Although I don't know if they are going for Mercia and they have already conquered the settlement on Northumbria. They might be coming back here. So we really need to stay focused on the Viking situation, because they are an ongoing faction. You know, their invasions are not only like this time. And they don't come back. No, they come back. They come back later. And it's not only them, you know. We have to be careful as well against the official Viking factions, like the Jarldom of Fatherland or the other dudes. I guess it's Vestfold. The other Viking faction, which is near us, and I know for a fact that one of them has for objectives to slay us and to eliminate the kingdom of Alba, so we have to keep that in mind. So I'm going to stop the pursuit just because I can't pursue much more. But there you go, Rig Causantine the Wine Bountiful lost almost 700 men, which is 30% of his forces, but we have slain almost every single one of the Viking's strongest force on Scotland. That was a pretty nice result for me. I mean, I will try to ransom them, see if they can give us some money. Well, they rejected, so they die. They die.
Glory to the king.
Glory, not glory to the king, glory to you. You are the king. To your expense, great warrior. Oh, hello there, Theodred. Not Theodred, sorry, Theoden from Lord of the Rings and Eomer. I like the picture you picked there. Great warrior. Ardent old brother in arms, always there to defend to the last or serve as a midfield mentor. Want a personal security, more want a command. Oh, there you go, look at that. 5 stars now. From 2 to 5. He did deserve that, didn't he? Good. So let's get him at Air, and let's get Artgull in Dumfries for now. And let's cancel that stuff, and let's retrain everybody we can here. And recruit that ship as well, because we will need it eventually. So that was a nice result, wasn't it? It really was.
Always ready to
steal
money.
Okay.
With us, noble one.
I'm a king.
Come up.
Yes, sire.
And I'm just going to finish up the turn so these guys can strike me and we can have this battle still today.
We bring word for you.
Trade rights? No, darling. I don't really want to have good relations with Northumbria. I need to eliminate you eventually. So there we go. I guess this is going to be a shorter battle. They still have some pretty nasty troops here. But, you know, I guess this will be much easier than the other one. At least I'm hoping for. Yeah, I know, we only have 20 minutes left on our time for the episode today, but, you know, episode, it might actually have more than, it's no big deal, I guess. At least you guys get two, which is always a nice thing, isn't it? Ooh, okay, I forgot that when they attack... we don't get any deployments. Archers. Come here. And infantry. Let's get there. Get our general on the flank. When our archers can shoot, let them shoot. There you go, Vikings. The Scots are coming back to retake what is rightfully theirs. Oh, and it is raining. It's a rainy day. Shoot them. Shoot them. And shoot them. I want to see those arrows flying. Even though the rain might stop some arrows from coming in. Let's get those dudes there to flank. Let's get those dudes there to flank. And let's get to the city center. They might actually not even realize I'm there. Let's see. Get all our infantry engaged.
The battle is very much in our favor.
Oh yes,
we
it is.
True and steadfast.
Very much in our favor. You can say that, my friend. Okay, they got to our flanks here. Really? Where's the timer? Should be the timer right there. Does it not exist on this mod? Can't be. Well, if it doesn't appear, let's go there and let's try to strike the archers down. With a nice charge. Okay, how are we doing here against the Erkelid Spearman? Not bad. Some of them should start routing once my general comes in. To charge their archers. Come on, Garrick McGrath. See why you are worthy your name. Okay, you stop firing now. Got engaged with some Viking. Okay, let's pull back. How are we doing? Yeah, nicely. Archers. Ah, shoot those dudes. Let's charge these Vikings. It's light infantry, so they... Yeah, the charge should be good. And it could be better, right? Let's disengage. The problem with disengaging is that we always get some casualties when we disengage. I'm actually losing some men here. I was hoping to lose like 10% or something. But I will definitely not be able to lose only that. Okay, let's get those dudes in range of our archers. Oh, no, they're coming for... Oh, this... This AI is actually very intelligent. They are coming for the back of my dudes here. Yeah, they are charging us. Oh god, you completely messed up the charge. Shit. They are holding pretty nicely. Look at this. Okay, charge them. Now they're routing. Oh, what the fuck was that, boys? What a crappy charge. Fuck you. Shoot them. Okay, go down. Bring those dudes down. Bring those. Go there. Go all in. Come on, archers, take those dudes down. Still 15 dudes fighting here. Yeah, these Vikings really fight till the very last, do they not? Oh, they want my horses so badly. We lost 20% of our forces right now. Guess you can lose like maybe a quarter. But I don't really want to lose much more than that, because then we have another army to face up there on the other island. Okay, but they are now falling to our arrows. Look at that. Oh, I really like to see that. And they don't even care. They don't even charge our archer. They just run past them. Yeah, Valhalla awaits you, boys. Valhalla fucking awaits you. My cav to charge some of these dudes. Maybe from the behind here. So I can make this a little bit easier. Look at this, still four of these dudes fighting. They're not routing, their banner is not. It's not white. Look how many Viking corpses here on the floor. The Scots are coming back home, boys.
By the saints, our men have slain the enemy general.
Without did we? His troops will another lose freaking captain. Fight. I guess they don't have any generals, do they? Only captains. A bit of a shame. they had a general, they would even have more morale. Can you imagine that? as if they didn't have enough already. Okay, let's try to charge them on the back here. See if we can get a good charge. Oh god, he has like three dudes coming from around here. I see, Garrick McGrath, you are a very promising general. You've done your work against the rebels. Now, do it against the Vikings on defending your motherland. You're not doing. Go back. Don't want you to die here. Okay, I guess now we can fast forward this a little bit. Because there's not too much more to control here. Just watching those guys getting slaughtered. Just try another charge here. Let's try to watch it. Ooh. That should be nice. No, that was not nice. Get out of there because you are losing men again. Oh, these guys are tough as iron. Look at that. Get all involved. Push. Come on, man. Push. I had to show you the battle with a little bit of zoom in now. Just don't die. Try to charge up again. Yeah. Every time he goes there, he loses like three or four men, but at least he got a silver chevron there. It was good. I might even send my archers in, why not? As infantry. All Scottish men coming to reclaim what is rightfully theirs. One of the other little isles of Scotland. Which the name I forgot, because the names are so freaking confusing. Yes, now they are going down. Yeah. Still like one dude fighting, probably. Or two. There they go. This is a great victory. Heroic victory, Garrick McGrath. I wouldn't call it heroic. The other one was an heroic one. This was just a clear victory, I guess. Yeah, we lost 22% of our forces. Unfortunately, we can't retrain anybody. So next time, really see what strategy will we take against the Viking army, which is on the northern part, on this island. If we let him come to us and we defend inside here, or if we go against him, we're probably gonna need the aid of some mercenaries though, because this army is really getting beaten down. He really needs to retrain. So let's just walk in. There you go. No thank you. Yeah, there's no way I can retrain. Oh, actually! I can retrain! The mercenaries. These dudes are mercenaries, yes. Well, I can retrain the mercenaries, that's not bad. That's not bad. Look at him! Well, I mean, when they face against Vikings, they get so many stars. 1, 2, 3, 4... 5, 6, 7. He had like 4. He has now 7. He got like extra 3 stars. That is pretty good. Oh, new family members. Mora and Morven. Ooh. another daughter to our king, and a daughter to our prince, Tanaiste, which is our brother, actually. And he's waiting at Inverness to go and take Vic, or Vike, or whatever. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. He still has a spot for one more unit. So I pretty much just need to wait 9 more turns and then he's ready to go there. It's not that bad. It's not that bad. Let's get a trader here, which is always an essential thing to get. What can we get here? Nothing of interest, really. Oh, we can upgrade this. Good. That's what I'm talking about. Northumbrian princess. Where's my diplomat?
Can I be of service?
Kinyod, there you go. Okay, I'm going to put you on that ship. And we're going to Normandy. There you go. I'm going to take 1, 2... Only 3 turns. That's pretty nice. I'm waiting for those trading posts. 2 turns here, 3 turns there, so I can get some more merchants. Now everything is looking nice. We are going to see what this army does. I kind of wonder if they have ships to come here. I wonder. Maybe they actually don't. We'll see. Here we will keep on recruiting Tanaiste's army, so I can go to Vik and then to Kirkjubvegr. Oh god. As I say, the names are just awful. Here we are going to keep on retraining our king's force, which instantly lost all the stars he had. I guess it was only for one turn. And then we are probably going to put him on a ship and start taking on the Irish. I don't know if we're going to go already for the Irish lands. I guess he's going to wait there until we have wiped out all of the Viking forces from Scotland, and when we have unified all of Scotland, including all these little islands here in the north, then we're going to pick up the 3 armies, Garrick MacGrath, Tanaiste, and our kings, and with the 3 armies we're going to invade Ireland. I guess it's better to, you know, to invade with a larger force, or a large number of forces, than with just one army. And we have to leave a regional defensive army, probably at Inverness, just so it can keep there, in case the other Viking nations decide to come at us. And I know for a fact that, I guess, is, I don't know if it's Orthaland or if it's Vestfold, one of the Viking factions which is based here, it has the objectives to eliminate us, so they probably will come at us eventually. So that's it, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Thank you for your support, and thank you for your comments and everything, and I'll see you next week with another episode of this great campaign. So see ya.